Good morning. Pems listen to VOA, Japanese English listening material site. In the 1970s, there was that oil shock. At the time of this oil shock, the Middle East stopped selling oil to developed countries. The commodity price in Japan is said to be frenzied, and the price of electricity is going up. And all the late-night programs on that TV have been discontinued. There was a tough time when the toilet paper price had risen to a tremendous amount because it was all about energy conservation. When Japan was finally recovering economically, oil ran out and the factory stopped. Electricity bill went up. It was a really difficult time. At the time of this oil shock, Japan was going to negotiate with Saudi Arabia to sell oil to Japan. There was a politician at that time, Yasuhiro Nakasone, who was Minister of International Trade and Industry after became Prime Minister of Japan, and then Masayuki Fujio, acting as the representative of the then Nakasone. Later, Fujio did the Minister of Education. He went to Saudi Arabia and asked it to sell oil. It was Indonesia that acted as an intermediary in helping Japan when Japan asked for the oil. Because Saudi Arabia and Indonesia are the same Islamic countries. There was a deputy prime minister called Aramsha who was the deputy prime minister of Indonesia at the time. And this person was behind negotiations to help Japan to buy oil from Saudi Arabia. Mr. Aramsha arranged Japan was able to buy oil. I got a chance to have an interview this Mr. Aramsha 1995. I've heard about it at my home in Jakarta. At that time, when I went to see him, he had received a medal of the first degree from His Majesty the Emperor, and he showed me the medal of the medal first he brought me. I was so thankful I received it from His Majesty the Emperor. When I asked, why were you able to get, he replied because Emperor appreciated him for his hard work during the oil shock. Then I asked Mr. Aramsha, why did you help Japan? Although I said, His Excellency, it was Your Excellency Aramsha in my words. Then, he's an international person because he's already a deputy prime minister. So he's fluent in English, but when I said, he responded, I think Japan fought the Greater East Asian War to help Asia and Africa to speed up independence from Europe. Isn't it natural for us to give back? So after the war ended, did you help Japan 20 years later? He said, oh, it's not good just to get help. I have to help Japan. The feelings of the countries, including Indonesia, were not talked about during the Great East Asian War. What wasn't it talked? The reason is simple. And one of the countries that judged Japan at that time was the Netherlands. What did the Netherlands do during the Tokyo trial? Indonesia had been a Dutch colony for long years. However, the Japanese army, the Great East Asian War triggered Indonesia, declared its independence on August 17, 1945. The Netherlands was once again invading Indonesia, claiming not to accept its independence. The Dutch country that was invading Indonesia was judging that Japan is an invasion. Should it be silly? It's a word of really stupid. However, it totally ignored the opinions of those Asian people and said that only Japan was bad. Propaganda was done, and in fact, the United States, the Soviet Union, the United Kingdom, China, etc., were working on various works in order to drive Japan into the war. That thing wasn't even effort at all. Then, information disclosure has started since the 1990s on various things that the United States, Britain, and the Soviet Union have worked on and in each country. 50 years after the war ended in 1995, and 50 years later, various materials including the war were released to the public. In fact, the fact that only Japan was bad is different began to appear. That's all. Thank you. Listen to VOA.